Hello everyone, today I would like to speak a little bit about the Geofencing API. Geofence is a virtual location-based boundary or a barrier that is usually used for mobile devices. And I say mobile devices mean assets that are mobile, like your truck or a person using a phone or a bicycle or your automobile. Once we have the assets, we can use geofences to detect if the asset is inside or out or have been crossing, and we can send notifications or detect a specific behavior or create a specific action that happens when the boundary is being crossed, for example. Geofences application mostly depend on the APIs that store the location of the asset that you want to track, or an API that allows you to create these geographical or geometrical assets. Despite these capabilities, many developers make minimal use of geofences, creating only, for example, squares and circles, but they can be much more than that. So today we're going to explore some advanced uses for the TomTom Geofencing API. We are not only squares and circles. Many applications provide promotions or offers depending on the location of the user of the mobile device, for example. Let's say it could be a shopping center, or could be even a parking lot, or a entertainment district, etc. As well, many municipal projects depends on the location of the automobile on the roads. TomTom's Poi Search capability allows to find locations very easily and fast. This Poi Search save time is a one-step function for predefined locations. For example, imagine an application that works for an airport. When you are approaching the airport, not only go to the parking lot and go into the hall, and they automatically get notification that you must get a boarding pass at a certain location. For all this to work, we have to create the representation of the physical locations in a virtual fence. For that, we have the TomTom Geofences Creator, which we have a whole video here. With that, you can create this geometrical, but not only the squares and circles, but also corridors or different type of polygons. You decide what you want to do. With TomTom Geofencing API, you can create fences that are in any shape: rectangles, circles, corridor, polygon, and could be any size. The Geofencing API also interacts with the location history API in order to save and acquire the location of your assets. In this case, whoever is using the application, whoever is driving the auto, into your own backend, and we offer our own storage information for you to retrieve securely at any time. We can also make applications, let's say for parking application, helps you automatically add parking payment whenever your user enters the area of the parking lot, if they access to. While most process will happen server side, you might prompt the visitors to ask if they already are there and to confirm before you charge them. A corridor geofence includes a path and a radius. That means the thickness of the path. And this path could be like a straight line, could be like different twists and inclinations. And in fact, you can follow a defined route that you have created in advance. These are very useful for tracking assets or users that go, for example, in a specific roadway or even rivers. You can use a corridor geofence to track how many automobiles go into the road in and out. By using these corridors, cities can detect if there are slow movement in certain areas on the road and make decisions about traffic movement or traffic management. Additionally, the POI search can give you locations that are inside this corridor. This is useful to detect to see if you are in a specific area and you need to take a break, take a rest, or there's a location that you actually have to reach. So we can combine these two APIs, like the POI search and the Geofences Creator to manage and track using the Location History API or the Geofencing API, for example, for trucks that are on the road and you want to make sure that they follow a specific path, or if they go deviate and they recalculated the route, why they do that, and you can manage them better. As well, you can also create larger geofences to detect when the drivers are already close by to your location, so you can create a notification or warnings that you have to be prepared in advance. We can apply the same concept to many applications, tracking packages, for example, tracking users, and in combination with this POI search, it gets excellent results. In conclusion, geofencing is way much more than simple drawing circles and squares, as you can see. With the TomTom Geofencing API, you have the possibility to extend to a myriad of applications that have to be with tracking and serving your customer when they are close to a location. If you want to explore more about geofencing APIs and its solutions, check the developer portal in developer.tomtom.com, sign up for free for a free API key, and let us know how can we help you with it. Maybe you will make the next Pokemon Go application. Thank you for watching and happy mapping!